Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be this Valentine's Day soft romantic, sort of like a dusty rose eye and lip combo. I actually filmed this tutorial a little bit differently this time. I did not film me doing my moisturizer, primer, foundation, concealer, any of that. I started at the eyes and finished with bronzer, highlight, lips, blush, that whole thing. I really hope that you guys enjoy this video, and it's going to start off with me doing my eyes, and so from the eyes to the lips and the finished look. And yeah, so let's jump right in. Okay, so I have already moisturized, primed, foundation, powdered, concealed, put my eyebrows on, all of that. So pretty much I'm gonna go through and show you guys what all I've used on my face up to this point, and then this is going to pretty much just be an eye makeup tutorial, and then I'm gonna finish it off with my blush, bronzer, highlight, mascara, all of that at the end. First, I moisturized with my Garnier Clearly Brighter Brightening and Smoothing Daily Moisturizer. I love this stuff. I will say that it's probably better for summer than winter, but I do really like it. And then I went in with my Maybelline Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser to prime my face. And then I put on my Too Faced Born This Way foundation. If you have seen my tutorials in the past, you know this is a big favorite of mine. I use it a lot. I love it. I actually need a lighter shade though, because I haven't been out in the sun at all, and it's a little bit darker for me, but it blended okay. And this is a shade Warm Nude, if you guys are wondering. And I just used my Beauty Blender to apply that, and I went in with my Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer in the peach tone to cancel out my dark under eye circles, because I need it. And then I finished off my concealer with the Tarte Shape Tape, and I am in the shade Light, and this is my favorite concealer at the moment. I love it. It trumps my Kat Von D concealer, my Urban Decay, all of that. This is just my go-to. It's so awesome. And then I set my face with my NYX Finishing Powder, and this is in the shade Banana. Just looks like that. And then last, I set my concealer with my go-to Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder. You guys know I love this stuff. It's pretty much the only thing I set my under eyes with. And then I put on my Too Faced Shadow Insurance to prime my eyelids and get ready for the eyeshadow to go down. And then I used my Precisely My Brow Pencil by Benefit, and I am in the shade 3, or the number 3. I don't think they have names, so number 3. And then I use the Benefit Gimme Brow Brow Volumizing Fiber Gel in the shade 1. That is what I have done so far, and now I'm going to get into my eye makeup. So since I have already primed my eyelids, they are ready for eyeshadow to go down. They've dried and all that, and they're ready to go. So first, I'm gonna be using a couple different palettes because I don't have everything I need in just one palette, unfortunately. But I'm going to go in with my Makeup Forever Artist Eyeshadow Palette. It's the one with the matte colors, and it's got like the green, the pinks, the black, the gray, all of those tones. And I am going to go in with this really soft pink color right here, all over the lid. And I'm going to be using my Sephora Pro Blending Large 27 brush to do that. I did forget to mention though that I am leaving this off of my brow bone, so everywhere else but the brow bone. And I really want this to be a deeper pink, so I am building it up. If you're wondering why I keep going back over it, that is why. Once you get it built up, it kind of comes off as more of a dusty rose tone, which is actually what I'm going for. Kind of inspired by like my shirt color, so that worked out perfect. It's a really, really pretty pink color. And it's soft enough to where if you are like afraid of pinks, it's not going to be overwhelming and like, well, pink. It's got like a really soft look to it. Taking that same palette, I'm going to go in with the darker pink tone. I'm going to be using my Crown C330 Pro Blending Crease Brush and just deepening up that crease. Okay, so I'm gonna take a little bit more of a dense brush. This is the Crown SS012 Deluxe Crease Brush. And I'm gonna take that same darker pink and I'm gonna just focus it right on the outer corner there and just build it up so it's a little bit heavier. Alright, next I'm going to take my Sephora Professional Rounded Crease number 13 brush and blend. Now you could choose to stop here with the eyeshadow minus doing like the brow bone and stuff, but I am going to go in with my Too Faced Chocolate Bon Bon palette, and I'm gonna pick up the shade Cotton Candy right here, which has a little bit of a shimmer to it, not like glitter, but just like a sheen. And I'm gonna go in with my e.l.f. Professional Eyeshadow Brush. Just looks like that. It's a flat brush. Tap in there, and I'm gonna place it right on my eyelid. Going back over the outer corner, dragging the darker color back through. For the brow bone, again from the Chocolate Bon Bon palette, I'm going to use the shade Sprinkles right here. I'm taking my Sephora Pro Shader 18 to apply that. Also placing that on the inner corner. And I'm actually gonna go in with a little bit of a lighter shade for the inner corner because I feel like that's a little too pink. I'm gonna take my glow kit from Anastasia. This is the Gleam glow kit. And I'm going to take the shade Crushed Pearl, which is the lightest in the palette, and I'm going to place that on the inner corner because it still has a hint of like that pearly pink to it. I'm actually gonna place that at the center of my brow bone as well. And then blend. Okay, so you can choose to tweak this however you like if you feel like it's a little too pink. But once you have the eyeliner and the mascara on, it's gonna look a lot softer. If you choose to leave the pink shade in the Chocolate Bon Bon palette out, then it's gonna be a little bit of a softer pink look. But I really like the soft shimmer that the pink provides on the eyelid. Okay, so now we're going to line the lid. Doing a really soft line, wing, I should say. Oh my gosh. That's cute. This is the new style. Now you can totally use fake lashes for this. I think it'll really, really make this look stand out. I, however, am not going anywhere tonight. I'm not doing anything special. So I am just going to put mascara on and like really build up my lashes and go from there. For the bottom lash line, you could totally choose to leave it naked, put nothing on it. You could do an eyeshadow. You could do the black liner. I'm going to take a brown liner, like a deep brown liner, and line under there and just really kind of make it pop. I do not think that I like my eyes look good without anything underneath there. A lot of people can pull it off, but I don't feel comfortable not wearing it. So I'm going to use my NYX Glide On pencil in Brown Perfection. Oh, and I was using my Kat Von D ink liner. And I'm just gonna draw like a messy line under here. I'm gonna take my little smudgy tool and smudge away. And it's gonna give it like that nice soft line. And you can see already how different my eyes look. Like this one just looks more finished and awake and voila, where this one just to put my mascara on, and I'm going to use first the L'Oreal Voluminous Base Primer. I actually really, really like this mascara primer. I prefer it to my Dior Show primer, which people probably think is crazy, but it's less than half the cost of it, and it works better. For my mascara, I'm going to use my Lancome Hypnose Drama. I haven't used this in a really long time, so hopefully I like the results I see. Alright, not my favorite mascara, so I'm gonna actually go in with something else after I get this coat on. Not a fan of that mascara. So, back to the always reliable, Too Faced Better Than Sex, never lets me down. Just such a better mascara. And don't worry about all the mascara that I'm getting on my eyelid, I will clean it up. I literally can't prevent that. Either my eyelids are too big, my lashes are too long, or both. Can't prevent it. You don't want to clump your bottom lashes with mascara. You want it to be a little bit of a softer look under there. So just keep that in mind when doing the bottom lashes to only use a little bit for this look. Some looks, you know, really, if you want it to really pop and like have that dramatic effect, go for it. This one, keep it on the softer side. Okay, so I'm going to go in now and clean up my mess here. And it came off really easy because I let it dry. Now that we're finished with the eyes, I'm gonna zoom out a little bit and do my face. So I'm gonna go in with my bronzer, blush, and highlighter now to finish off this look and my lips. And then this look will be complete. So I don't want to heavily contour. I want it to be really soft. So I'm gonna go in with my Too Faced Chocolate Soleil. This is still like the way old packaging. I've had this forever. Still smells good, still kicking. And I'm gonna go in with my Crown Dome Blender, the C437. Swirl it around. I'm just gonna buff it into the skin. As a contour and a bronzer. So you don't want it to be heavily contoured or heavily bronzed. You kind of want it to be somewhere in between, nicely blended, nothing harsh. However, because I've put on so much pregnancy weight, I do really like to contour my chin line and get rid of my little excess we got going on there. So I like to go in with my CoverFX contour brush, the heavy side or the bigger side, and I'm gonna go right here, my jawline, and then right here, I put a whole lot of it. I'm gonna bring it up right here and right here. Then you're gonna take your fluffy brush again and just kind of buff it. Ever so lightly. Now I'm gonna go in with my MAC in Blush Baby. Just looks like that. It's like a really soft, dusty rose pink color. And I'm gonna go in with my Crown Angle Blush Brush. And it's like a really small blush brush. I'm gonna set that right on my cheekbone. To me, it just gives that like really soft, romantic vibe. It's not too overpowering or anything like that. I really like this color. It's great for weddings and prom, special occasions, Valentine's Day, any type of soft look you're going for, it's really good for. And even a heavy look, because it kind of balances out the heavy eyes, so. Okay, next I'm gonna go in with my highlight, and I'm taking my Anastasia Gleam Glow Kit, and I'm gonna go in again with that Crush Pearl Tone. And I'm going to use my Luxie 522 Tapered Highlighter brush. I like this brush a lot because it really gives it like a soft highlight instead of way overpowering highlight. Down the nose. course, Cupid's bow. And I'm just going to take a fluffy powder brush and blend ever so softly. That together. Okay, and so the last step is going to be lips. And I was sitting here before I filmed this look trying to decide what color pink I want to go with. And I have a few different shades here. I'm not going to show you guys all of them on my lips, but I'm going to show you them just as options. And then I'm going to pick one. So you could go the darker route and do the Anastasia Catnip, which is one of my personal favorites. But I want it to be a little bit softer than that. So you could go in with MAC Angel or MAC Snob or the Urban Decay Back Talk. They're all very similar shades, not gonna lie. The thing that would separate them from each other is putting on an iridescent-y gloss. So I have the Revlon Colorburst 002 Crystal Lilac, which looks like that, and it's got like a really, really iridescent-y glow to it. And you could totally just wear this on its own too, or put it on top of the lipstick, or you could do the Buxom lip gloss in Sophia. And this has a little bit more of a glitter to it, I would say. It's the top one right here. And it's a little bit softer. So I'm gonna go in with Angel. That's gonna be my lipstick of choice, just because it is really soft. I would say my personal two favorite choices would either be Angel or Back Talk. So Angel is the lighter and then Back Talk is the darker. And it just depends on if you want a lighter or a darker tone. Now, I don't really have a light lip liner. I don't have a whole lot of lip liner options. Like, I always think I do, but I actually don't. So I'm gonna use the one that I go to probably the most, my NYX Retractable Lip Liner in Nude Pink. I'm just gonna keep that line soft because I am gonna need to blend it out. Also, if you feel like you have like too much pink going on, which I don't feel that way, but if you do, you could totally wear like a nude lip. This is the finished look. I hope that you guys really like it, and I hope that you guys have a great Valentine's Day and you get some yummy dinner and a good date, and or even with your friends, cooking, just doing something fun, Galentine's, whatever. But yeah, so I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope that you are having a great week and you have a great Valentine's Day. And please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button. As I mentioned in one of my previous videos, I am going to be doing a 1,000 subscriber giveaway, so let's keep those numbers climbing. I hope you guys have a great rest of your night, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. Today I'm going to be filming my 21 to 23 week pregnancy update.
Don't give up.